exciting is it to join a show like this?
It's really exciting.
Yes.
Especially a show that's been going on for so long, because it's basically a well-oiled machine. And then when that happens, there's a lot of room for creativity and adding your own opinion and your own flair to certain aspects of the character. Because everybody's, you know, everything's figured out. All the hard stuff's been figured out, so now it's time to play and have fun, which makes season four really exciting, because we're trying things this year.
Now, what can you tell us about your character?
Oh, Jack. She's very special to me. She's a fighter at heart and on the streets, and she's fierce, and she's very loyal and independent, and she's very confident in her fighting ability, and sometimes that gets her into trouble, you know, when you're fighting vampires. But she's pretty cunning and fiercely loyal. That's how I love her. I really love her. She's strong.
And how did you prepare for this role? I mean, you're coming in as a new kid on the block. Were you nervous about it? Were you trying to do some training? Were you screening stuff? Were you a fan of the show before? I know I just asked you a ton of questions.
Nice. Pick one. I'll take them all.
I'm highly caffeinated right now, sorry.
Same. So to prepare physically at least, because that's kind of the first thing when I was auditioning for this, they said you have to be pretty physical, and so I said, okay, cool. So as soon as I heard that I was even in the running, I hadn't actually booked the job yet, I was like, I'm going to get a head start. So I went and took boxing classes, which I had kind of been doing before. I did a show called Defiance back in the day, and when I was there, I was training Muay Thai. So I actually did get to bring some MMA into this season, which is really exciting. But in terms of acting, I binge-watched all three seasons, which was not a hard task. It was really fun to watch. And it was cool to see how everybody grew from season one and then watch them on set on season four. It's fun. But yeah, that's kind of... I watched the show and I did my own like Jack preparations, but for physicality, it was a lot of weight training.
Who can we expect to see her like teaming up with or working with most?
I wish I could tell you.
Darn it.
But whoever it is, it's an awesome team.
Yeah.
And they kick a lot of ass together.
Nice.
Yeah.
Did they give you a big backstory for her?
Eventually.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. I had my own in my head.
Yeah.
And then I got one later. Pretty similar.
Okay.
But what I can say is she's been trying to find her way on the road since The Rising happened. And so that's why she's kind of MMA style, because she learned how to fight on the streets. But yeah, it's kind of all I can really say in terms of backstory. Sorry, I don't want to spoil it.
No, no way.
Do you get a list of things you can and can't talk about?
I have a list of things I can't talk about. There is no can't talk about this.
Now, you were on Defiance before this, and then now this. Do you have affinity for science fiction-based shows to watch and act in?
Oh, do I look forward to any? Is that what you just said?
No, do you have an affinity? Do you
enjoy
like
it?
Yeah.
Oh, yes, I love it. So, yeah. Defiance was great. That was my first taste, really, of TV. I got that when I was 18, and so I kind of grew up in the sci-fi world. And just filming sci-fi is really fun, because it's kind of it's very creative, because the writers always, usually there's a moral behind most of the stories.
Mm-hmm.
That's very political, or there'll be undercurrents of themes that are happening to our society now, and then they're reflecting it through like the lens of a science fiction, which is really fun, because then I feel like I'm telling important stories, or at least helping be a part of it. And then the fandoms are amazing on these shows, and I mean, I've been talking to people since I was 18, and it feels like family now. And this crossover actually between Defiance and Van Helsing, I noticed a lot of the supporters kind of jumped and went to Van Helsing also. So that was cool, because now I feel a little bit more like I'm coming to a family reunion instead of like a group full of strangers that are really nice.
So they were a very welcoming cast.
Yeah, the cast was very welcoming. As soon as I got to set, my first day was a fight scene, and everybody was like, don't worry, they do this to everybody. Cool, sweet. And everybody, was any questions you had about theme or tone. Jonathan Scarf directed one of the episodes, and that was really helpful for me. And everybody just, yeah, everybody's in the boat of, we can make everyone, if we can raise everybody up, the whole like level gets better. And it's not like a, it's not an in yourself type vibe. Everybody's trying to make everyone rise up, which is cool. You don't get that all the time.
No.
Yeah.
Did Jonathan give you any advice as a young actor?
Did he? I'm sure he handed a lot of advice while we were filming. Basically what I get from Jonathan is to relax and enjoy yourself while you're there. Because, you know, that's the moment you have. So do with it what you can. And don't be afraid to take some risks when you're filming. Don't be afraid to crack a couple jokes. He loves to do a couple taglines at the end. I feel like the blooper reel this year will be a lot of his one-liners, but they're all really great.
Does she have a tagline? Is there something we're going to see referenced multiple times?
Patricia?
Yeah.
She has a couple things she does with her physicality.
Okay.
And watching her work was really cool. I got to watch her work pretty closely, and she's just really talented, and her process is really fun to watch. And I think everybody's gonna love what she decided to bring to the table for this one.